Hi, I'm Muriel, and I'm going to walk through a tutorial called Music Maker. Music Maker is an App Inventor app that lets you mix your own sounds with, for example, drums, beats, or pianos. Mix them together and make your own creations. Now, we'll be going through a tutorial with pre-made sounds and pre-uploaded images, but you're welcome to adapt this to make your own. Before we get started, I'm just going to show you a quick demo of what a completed Music Maker app looks like so that we know what we're aiming for. Let's take a look now. Here's a quick demo of what the completed app will look like. You can see that we'll have four buttons for four different types of music and four buttons to stop those four different types of music. When you press on them, you can make sound, and when you press the stop button, it turns off. And you can see it stopped when I press the corresponding stop button. You can even mix musics by pressing two. And that's what we're going to be making in this video tutorial. Let's go ahead and get started.
Okay, so the first thing you want to do is download the Music Maker template that's linked in the description of this video. And then go to the App Inventor page, ai2.appinventor.mit.edu. Once you have it downloaded, go to Projects and Import Project from My Computer. And then you can browse through your files, select the template file, and press OK. It should open up automatically. The reason we're using a template file is because it has all of the images and sounds preloaded for you, as well as a sample layout. Okay, so here's the template as it should open up on your screen. As you can see, there's already a lot set up. The first thing that I want to show you is here in the media drawer, the WAV files and also the JPEG and PNG files, which are images. And these will be the sounds that your instruments can make, as well as the icons of the images. So for example, this is drum1.png, this is piano1.png. So what we're going to be doing with this Music Maker is setting up an app that lets you play music with various sounds. So we're going to have a drum sound, a piano sound, and any other sounds that you want to add yourself. And also have a start and a stop button that will allow it to play. So this is a suggested layout for you. You can do it in any layout you want, any layout that makes sense. I will be demonstrating one later as well. Now let's take a quick look at the components here in the upper right-hand corner. We, of course, have the screen. And then there are horizontal and vertical arrangements nested into each other. These are just ways to set up where the buttons are going to be on screen. So for horizontal arrangements, anything that's inside a horizontal arrangement is just placed side by side with each other, left to right. This is different from the default up and down arrangement that App Inventor usually uses. Vertical arrangement is the same thing. Anything inside this vertical arrangement is vertical. So you first have the drum and then you have the piano. So you can see that there are vertical arrangements and horizontal arrangements. Some of them are nested inside of each other, and it's very handy for setting the app for how you want. Now I'm going to do a slightly different arrangement to demonstrate. You're welcome to keep this arrangement, do the arrangement that I'm going to do, or make up your own. It definitely all works. Okay, so first I want to actually go to the screen and go to the properties. Scroll down and set the screen orientation to be landscape. This is just personal preference here. And now it looks fairly squished, so let's change it up. I'm going to delete this button just by pressing the delete button here. I'll delete button 7, I'll delete button 8, and I'll replace it with these images instead. Now you can see that this button is now way too big, right? So instead, we need to change its sizing. Let's look at this image. You can see that its height is fill parent and its width is 20% of the screen's width. So let's do the same thing for this. Its height is going to be fill parent and its width is going to be 20%, so about a fifth of the screen. There, that looks a lot better. Now let's do the same thing for this piano. Height, fill parent, that means it takes up as high as it can, and width is 20%. All right, this is looking pretty good. Now we need some stop buttons for all of these. So these are already buttons, buttons 11 and button 12, but instead of gray, let's make them a brighter color. So go to, make sure you have button 11 selected, go to background color, and let's set it to yellow. And same thing, button 12, background color, maybe red this time. And let's have the button say stop. So go to this button 10, go text, have it say stop. And button 11, stop. Button 12, stop. Okay, and now we don't really need anything that's in this upper horizontal arrangement. So I'm just going to delete this top horizontal arrangement. And be careful, that's going to delete everything that's inside of it. I'm doing this because I know I don't need anything that's inside of it, but always be careful when you do it for your own projects. Delete. And here we go. This is a pretty good Music Maker layout. Now, there's one more thing that we want to do with the layout, which is, see how they're called button 5, button 6, 1, 2, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's really confusing to have the components just be numbered buttons. So I'm going to rename these to be more relevant. So for example, the drum button or the stop button. I'm going to rename these in a cut right now. You can rename them in any way that is understandable to you. But just keep in mind that we'll be using these buttons in the block section when we actually code the app. And so you want to be able to remember them easily. As a quick demo, let me rename one of these buttons. So this button 5 here, this is the one that makes the beat go, so I'm going to name it related to that. And I'm going to call this beat 1 button, and then I'm going to press OK, and you can see that it's been renamed in the components. So go ahead and pause the video now, rename all the other buttons in a way that's understandable to you, and we'll get back after you do that. Okay, after a short pause to rename all the buttons, I am back. So here you can see that I've renamed the two rows of four buttons. The top row is going to be the buttons that play the sound for the drums, the beat, etc. The bottom row is going to be the buttons that stop the respective sounds. So the blue stop button is going to stop the beat, and the purple stop button is going to stop that piano one. I think just about now is probably a good time to test out your app, see how it looks like on your mobile device. Remember to do that, you can scroll up and go to Connect and then AI Companion. This will bring up a QR code. Don't my QR code, make sure to scan your QR code using the MIT App Inventor Companion and your mobile device. You can also connect using emulator or USB if you don't have a mobile device. Let me demo how it looks like on my device. All right, now here's the layout that I've made. Your layout is, of course, welcome to be different. You can also use the original layout in the tutorial. All the buttons are here. This is going to be the four buttons that make music, and these are the four buttons that stop music. Right now, they don't work yet, but that's what we're going to implement next. Come and join me for the next part, where we'll be setting up the code and the players. And now with the layout all looking good, finally, we want to set up the code so that when you press the music button, it will start the sound. And when you press a stop button, it will stop the sound. What we're going to do here is I'm going to show an example for the beat button, but the idea is the same for all four or more of the buttons. So first, you're going to need a component that can actually play the sound. So let's scroll down to media and pull out a player. Drag it onto the screen, doesn't matter where in, and it's going to show up at the bottom in non-visible components. This is because the player doesn't actually show up on screen, but it works in the background to play whatever sound. So click on player one in components, and I'm going to rename it. I might call it, since this is for beat, I'm going to call it beat one player. And then in its properties, I'm going to check the loop button. That way it's going to play over and over again until it's the stop button is played. And then we're going to go to the source and we're going to call it beat1.wave. This is a wave file, a sound file that was pre-uploaded for you. You can of course use your own sound. Okay, now this is set up. Let's go to the blocks in the upper right-hand corner. And so what do you want to have happen? Well, when the beat 1 button is pressed, then we want to play the sound. So when beat 1 button dot click, drag that out, and then go down to the beat 1 player, call beat 1 player dot start. So that's play the sound that we set it to do. Now let's stop the sound. It's the same idea. So go to the stop beat 1 button and do when stop beat 1 dot click. Well, we're going to call beat 1 player dot stop. And it's as simple as that. Now what you want to do, go back to the designer and drag in more players, one for each of the sounds. Make sure to set its properties correctly by setting the loop and the source. And then, of course, set up the code in the block section. I'm going to pull up the block so that you can see this again. Go ahead and pause the video and do the rest for the rest of your sounds. After that, we'll test out the app. Okay, so here is the completed app. I have the 4 instruments covered, beat 1, piano 1, drum 1, and piano 2. Let's take a look in the blocks. And you can see that for each of the 4 instruments, I have a start case and a stop case. Feel free to pause here and copy this over if you haven't gotten it already. And then I'm going to be able to test out the app and show you how it looks completed. If you've gotten this far and your app looks the same as mine, or if it looks the same with your own layout, then congratulations, you've completed the Music Maker App Inventor tutorial. There are lots of ways that you can expand this app. First of all, you can certainly add more instruments and more sounds. You can upload them yourself into the media drawer by uploading them with this button. You can also go ahead and use a new button from the user interface to actually record and then play back the music that you make. You can also add a pause button. So instead of just stop, you can have pause, and you can set the start and stop instead of being 2 different buttons. You can just make it 1 button that's a toggle. As you can see, there's lots of different options for you to test it out. I'm going to end with a final demo, and congratulations on completing this tutorial.
Okay, and here is the completed app. You can see that it has all the layout, but now when we press on the buttons, it starts playing the sounds. You can press stop to stop it. The great thing is that you can actually mix several sounds together. So maybe I want to start the piano, and also the drum, and give it my own beat. And at this point, congratulations on completing the tutorial. Feel free to go ahead and implement any of the suggestions I've offered, and good luck.